This Traction Waveform tutorial looks at how to do sidechain compression in Traction Waveform Free and Waveform Premium. It's very easy to do, and I'm using free plugins that are included with Waveform in this demo. I'm Zane. Welcome to Simple Green Tech, where I do weekly audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you conquer the tech and unleash your creativity. Now, if you need to grab a copy of Waveform, I've included a link to it in the description below, along with some other useful links you might want to check out. So be sure to look down there for that. Now, let's jump into this Waveform tutorial. All right, very quickly, I'll explain sidechain compression. Basically, it's when you use one source or track to control the compression on another track. And this can be very helpful to duck a bassline out of the way when the kick hits, or you can use it to duck the music while your vocal goes over top of it. It can also be used in musical ways to create some new sounds. There are lots of creative ways that you can use sidechain compression, and Traction Waveform makes it extremely easy. Now, if you have the latest version of Waveform installed, I believe it turns on plugin sandboxing by default, so I recommend turning that off for this, as it will make things a lot easier. And then to turn it off, just go up to Settings, down to Plugins, and then down here you'll see Enable Plugin Sandboxing, and you just want to click it off. And then it's going to pop up saying that you'll have to close any projects that you have open and then reopen them in order for it to take effect. So do that if you have a project open. And once that's ready, go into your project or open a new one and create a baseline and also bring in a drum track. So for this, I'm using the Micro Drum Sampler, which is free in both versions of Waveform. And I'm also using the 4OSC Synth, which again is free in both versions of Waveform. Here's the drum track that I came up with. All right, just a basic little drum track there. And now here is the bass line that I'm going to be using with the 4OSC. Now let's listen to what they sound like when I play them both together. That bass line is kind of over top of everything. So what I'm going to do is add the sidechain effect to the bass line so the drum track will control the compression on the bass. So just right click in this area over here on your bass line track, go to add new plugin. I'm going to use the Waveform compressor / limiter. And if it loads on the left side of your instrument, you want to drag it over to the right side. And here is our compressor. And you see up here it says sidechain none. So click on that. And then you choose the track that you want to control the sidechain. And for this, the drum track is track 3. And now down here you see sidechain. Let's turn it on. And I'm going to turn it on full so we get the full effect of this. And now let's play it back and then I'll mess around with these settings. So you can hear how the drum beat is affecting that bass line, and it kind of creates some space for the kick drum in there. So let's listen to it without and then with. And it really creates some interesting movement to that bass line so it's not so stale. So that's using the drum track to affect the sidechain of the bassline, and we're also listening to the drum track. But you can also mute the drum track, and it will still affect the bassline. So if you wanted this bassline to be affected by that drum track, but you didn't want that actual drum track in there, you can still have that same effect. Let's listen to how that sounds. And you can hear that it was still being affected by that drum beat, even though we weren't listening to the drum beat. And this can work really well with a droning sound like a pad or a droning bass. And I'm going to show you that right now. But first, I want to ask, if you're enjoying this video and getting some value out of it, can you please give it a thumbs up? It really helps my channel out and I appreciate it so much. Now back into the Traction Waveform tutorial. So I have another instance of Micro Drum Sampler loaded on this track. And you'll see it's just a basic kick drum. So let's listen to how the drum track sounds on its own. All right, so that is the drum beat that we're going to use to control the sidechain of this instance of the 4OSC, which I have a pad loaded onto. So here's what the pad sounds like on its own. Just kind of boring, keeps going on, droning in the same sort of sound. So let's listen to what both of these sound like together without the effect on. All right, kind of boring. Now let's enable the compression, set the sidechain as track 3. It's already turned on. I have some settings already in there. And let's play both of these together now. And you can really hear the effects of the compressor whenever the kick drum comes in. Now, let's just do it without hearing the kick drum. So we're going to mute that track, and we're just going to hear the effect of the drum track on the pad without hearing the drums. So that's pretty cool. It's created something different from a rather droning sound. Now let's play it with that other drum beat that we had. So here's what this drone sounds like without the effect, with the other drum beat. Now here it is with the sidechain being controlled by this muted drum track. And of course, there's so much more you can do with sidechaining. Now, if you want to check out some of the best free compression plugins available right now, click up here or click down here to see what YouTube thinks you should watch next. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos from me. Thank you so much for watching. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.